Vagishadya sumanasakam sadvarthanam upakrame yamnatva kritakatya syuhutam namamigajananam parthaya pratibodhitam bhagavata narayanena swayam vyasena kratitam purana munina madhye mahabharatam advaitamamritavarshinim bhagavatim ashtadashadhyayinim ambatva manusandadami bhagavadgite bhavadveshinim Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim yat kripa tamaham vande paramananda madhavam sada shiva samarambham shankara acharya madhyamam asmada acharya paryantam vande guru paramparam yoginam vishwanathakyam asmattata swarupinam atmalabhat param labham vaktaram nakadachana Gita Tagranta Kataram Sri Gurum Pranamam Yam Yonta Pravishyame Vacham Dritim Buddhim Prachodayat Om Namah Sabha Sabha Pati Bhyascha Om Namah Om. Friends, we are going to be doing Gita Regimen for Advaitic Living, session number 23 today. We are somewhere near shloka number 13, so I will begin with that. Chaturvarnyam maya srishtam gunakarma vibhagasaham tasya kattaram apivam vidhya kattaram avyayam. Last time I showed you a URL which contains an article written by me on the Varna system. That Varna system is an explanation of this shloka. Actually, the explanation comes in the 18th chapter, elaborately in four shlokas. We are not taking that explanation now, but I had asked you to perhaps familiarize yourself with it, because you will certainly have a lot of questions about this Chaturvarnyam. Chaturvarnyam maya srishtam gunakarma vibhagasaha maya chaturvarnyam srishtam. I created this four varnas, the four varna system. Remember, varna is, does not mean caste. Caste is man-made. Varna is already here because it is already ingrained in us because of our characteristics, of our past actions, thoughts, etc., and our vasanas. Guna karma vibhagasaha. According to our gunas, gunas are constituents of the prakriti. That is sattvam, rajas, tamas. These three are the qualities, constituents of the prakriti. So we have imbibed various types of sattvam, various measures of rajas and tamas. So according to that, we have been, we have got a certain varna in this birth. That is what this says. I created this, says the Lord. And then in the next line he says, Tasya kartaram apimam vidya kartaram avyayam. I am the doer of that. Also understand, I am not the doer of that. Vidya kartaram. Akartaram means not the doer. Kartaram means doer. So I am the doer. Understand me as the doer. And then in the same breath he is saying, understand me, I am not the doer. This akartaram avyayam. I am the imperishable non-doer, he says. Now, this four varna system, I told you the explanations will come in the 18th chapter, but still I will give you a glimpse of what it is. You see, there are three qualities, sattva, rajas, tamas. Whatever thoughts we have done, we have thought about in the past births, not only one birth, several births, several lives, the thoughts, our actions, our tendencies, all those things shape us. It gives a certain flavor, to our entire characteristic. A certain type of, actually Krishna discusses six things. In deciding this flavor, he takes up the subject, he takes up the ideas, knowledge, action, doer, buddhi, intellect, and then dhriti, fortitude, and happiness. Six things. These six things, under for each of these, he describes what is the sattva, what is the rajas, what is the tamas type of knowledge, what is the tamas type of action, what is the tamas type of doer, similarly what is the rajas type of doer. So 6 times 3, 18 shlokas, he describes each of these. And we might fall in each one of that, in any one of them. That is, for knowledge we will fall into one of that 3 types, sattvam, rajas, tamas. For action we will fall into one of that type, rajas, tamas. So there are and if you make a calculation of these various types that one can produce out of that, it comes out to be about 28 types, and these are divided into 4 characteristics, 4 character types. What is the 4 character? How did you get the 4 character types? Krishna discusses that in the 18th chapter, and Shankara Bhashya explains it very clearly. That is, when the sattva dominates, when the sattva dominates, on the whole, totally, there is a domination. You see? So, if the sattva dominates, that is one varna. If the rajas dominates, but sattva is the next dominating factor, that is the next varna. If the rajas dominates, and the tamas is the next dominating factor, that is the third varna. If the tamas dominates, that is the fourth varna. This is the general type. I have discussed that in that article, long article, of course. It has some little mathematics also in it, but I am sure you will relish it. Right now it is not relevant. The point here is, chaturvarnyam maya srishtam, by me this varna system was created. By how was it created? According to the divisions of guna and karma, according to the divisions of the qualities and the actions. And I am the doer, I am the non-doer. Now, today we are going to go from shloka 13 to shloka 23. I have taken this large piece because all of this is the starting point of a major undercurrent of the Gita, which is actionlessness, naishkarmyam. The word was used in the third chapter, in the beginning, naishkarmyam. So by somebody keeping quiet, just by keeping quiet, one does not read, one does not reach the state of actionlessness, says he in the fourth shloka of the third chapter. Na karmanam anarambhate na ishkarbhyam purushosnute. By not starting an action, by not starting any action, one does not reach the state of actionlessness. So that actionlessness is the topic today. It is a very difficult topic, but it is the undercurrent in the Gita, and without that the Gita will not make sense. It is there all throughout, and the real full import of it you will understand only when you come to the 18th chapter. So that is why here he says, Tasya kartaram apimam vidhi akartaram abhyayam. I am the doer, understand me also as the non-doer. I am the non-doer. This is the actionlessness that he is talking about. He is going to tell us to get into the habit, get into the practice, get into the mood of actionlessness, attitude of actionlessness. But before that, he is telling you, he is himself of that type. He is himself actionless. Tasya kartaram apivam vidhya kartaram avyayam. We will have occasion to come back to the same topic again and again throughout the Gita. Therefore, now I go to the next shloka. Shloka number 14. Namam karmani limpanti name karma phale spraga itimam yobhijanati karma bhirna sabadyate. You see, this chapter started with the avatara concept. After he told you about the avatara, he talked about the karma yoga. In this world, in this human world of actions, actions give you fruits. quickly, he said. That is why all the people, even the divines, come here to do their tapas and so on. That is because of the Chaturvarnyam that I have created, namely the Varna system that I have created and the regulations that I have prescribed for that. But he says, I know none of my actions. If you think they are my actions, none of my actions will touch me. Namam karmani limpanti, mam karmani na limpanti. Karmani actions na limpanti will not touch me, will not pollute me, will not contaminate me. Name karma phale spriha. For me, there is no karma phale spriha. Spriha means desire. Karma phale means the fruits of actions. I am not interested in the fruits of my actions. I am not, that is why nothing will touch me. You see, the standard rule is 2nd chapter, 47th shloka. Karmanya eva adhikarasse ma phaleshu kadachana. Your right is only for action, not in the fruits of actions. He says, I am like that. Namam karmani limpanti, namai karma phale spriham. Very often in the Gita you will find, wherever he gives you some instruction to do it this way, somewhere, either before or after, he would have told you, he himself is of that type. So, namam karmani limpanti, namai karma phale spriham. Shloka number 14. No actions will touch me, and I have no interest in any of the fruits, spriha, desire. I have no desire for the fruits of my actions. Iti maham yo bijanati. Thus, whoever understands me, iti, thus, maam, me, yo bijanati, whoever understands, yaha bijanati, iti maam yo bijanati, karma bhirna sabadhyate, he will not be touched by any of his actions. He will not be bound, badhyate. He will not be bound, karma bhirna sa badhyate. That is, the actions will not touch me. I have no desire for any of the fruits of my actions. If you understand me like that, naturally you will also follow me like that. You see? So, karma bhirna sa badhyate. He will not be touched or contaminated by his actions. This is the way people have done all along. Evam nyatva. See, I am not tired of telling you that the Gita is a continuous flow of thought from the Lord's mind. If you read it together in Sanskrit or in the translation, together shloka by shloka, one by one, you will see the flow of thought coming very beautifully. So here he says, thus thinking, thus understanding, evam nyatva. Evam nyatva, shloka number 15. Evam nyatva kritam karma purvairapi mumukshubihim. Purvairapi, earlier people, ancestors, our ancestors who are seekers who wanted moksha. Purvairapi mumukshubihi. Evam nyatva kritam karma. Thus understanding me, they have done their job, they have done their work, they have done their actions. They have done their, discharge their prescribed obligations. Evam nyatva karma kritam purvairapi mumukshubihi. In fact, in the Ramayana, you know, when Rama, in the Ramagita lecture, if you have heard it, you would have known, Rama tells Bharata, Arey Baba, our ancestors have gone this way. We have to go in the same path. You cannot strike a new path. Because they have done it, they have shown us the way, that is the path we have to show. So the same idea he uses here. Purvairapi mumukshubihi, evam nyatva kritam karma. They have understood this and they have done actions. Kuru karma eva tasmatvam. So therefore, tasmat, tvam kuru karma, do your actions, do your prescribed duties. Discharge your prescribed obligations. Kuru karma. This is the Gita regimen. You see, we are asking what is the Gita regimen for Advaitic living. He is telling you, Kuru karma eva tasmatvam purvaiv purvataram kritam. Just the way our ancestors they did. In the same way, Kuru Karma. Astija Janakadeha, Karmanaivaki Samsiddhim, Astija Janakadeha, says Shloka number 20 of the third chapter. Janaka and other people, you see, they have all done it, done the obligations, discharged their obligations, did it this way. What way is it? The yajna way. Yajna arthat karmanon yatra. So, only as a yajna, they have done all their duties, all their obligations, all their work, all their even other actions, only as a yajna. So, evamnya atva kritam karma purvairapi mumukshubihim kuru karma ivatas matvam purvai purvataram kritam. Thus understanding, do your that is how the people, our ancestors, have done their job. The same way, do your karma also, discharge your obligations also, just as they did. Actually, there is a confusion in understanding this action and not doing action. Even among wise people, there is a confusion. So Krishna is a kind of agony here. Kim karma, next shloka, number 16. Kim karma, kim akarma, kim karma, kim akarma, what is action? Kim karma, what is action? Kim akarma, what is non-action? Akarma, kim akarma, what is non-action or inaction? Iti kavayopyatra mohitaha. Even wise people, kavayaha, scholars, well-knowing people who know things, kavayopi atra mohitaha, they are confused. Therefore, te tat te karma pravakshyami yajnatva mokshyase ashubhat. Shloka number 16, second line. Therefore, I am going to tell you about karma. I am going to tell you about action. I told you we are talking about actionlessness. So this whole section from shloka number 13 to shloka number 23 is about actionlessness. So he tells you about karma, action and non-action and wrong action. He is going to tell you three things. Wrong action. So in that non-action, so karma, action and non-action, he is going to give you a famous shloka in number 18. We are coming to it presently. So he is slowly getting into the topic of actionlessness. He is preparing the ground. Tatte karma pravakshami yajnatva mokshase shubhat. By my explanations about this karma and akarma, action and non-action, by my explanations of this, karma pravakshyami, I will tell you, yajnatva, by knowing this, mokshase ashubhat, you will be released from all inauspicious things. That is, you will reach salvation, you will reach moksha. That's the meaning of that. Kim karma kima karmeti kavayopyatra mohito. Even scholars are confused about karma and akarma, action and non-action. Excuse me. So even scholars are confused about action and non-action. Therefore, I am going to tell you about this karma. By knowing that, you will be released from all inauspiciousness. Mokshase ashubhat. Before actually saying that, he again prepares you. Karmano hyapi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmanaham, akarmanascha bodhavyam, gagana karmano gatihi. Shloka number 19. See, as I have told you, Krishna is a very good teacher. He is going to tell you something, so he tells you, I am going to tell you. And then before he tells you that, he tells you the greatness of what he is going to tell you. And then he tells you. And then after that, he will going to say, I have told you. This is the way the teacher catches the attention of the student. Karmano shyapi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmana. One should understand about karma, about action. Karmano shyapi bodhavyam, one should understand even about karma. Bodhavyam cha vikarmana. Vikarma means wrong action. Vikarma, wrong action. So one should know about action. One should know also about api, also about wrong action. Akarmanascha bodhavyam. Akarmana is non-action. Akarmanascha bodhavyam. So there are three things. Karma, vikarma, akarma. Karma is action. Vikarma is wrong action. Akarma is non-action. Some books translated as inaction, but inaction, I think probably is a wrong translation. I would prefer non-action. So, action and non-action, in between there is a wrong action also. Karma, all these things you should know. Karmano shyapi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmanah, akarmanascha bodhavyam. Gahana karmano gatihi. Beautiful statement. Gahana, oh, very difficult, very mysterious, very difficult to understand. Secretive is karmanaha gatihi. Karma's way, the karma's path, the path of karma, you see, the way of karma is very difficult to understand, is very mysterious. Gahana karmano gatihi. I remember this statement dramatically, because anytime something unpleasant, usually anytime some unpleasant news comes, you know, in a family there are several things might happen, from relatives, from friends, or for us, whatever. So whenever something happens like that, my father used to say, he will not immediately be depressed, or he will not go to a weeping state or anything. Whatever has to be done next, he will take the next step. But one statement he will make, gahana karmano gatihi. All this is the doing of karma, you see. Oh, somebody might die even. Gahana karmano gatihi. So karmano shyapi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmanaham, akarmanascha bodhavyam, gahana karmano gatihi. That is shloka number 17. Now we are going to go to very important shloka, a 5-star shloka, number 18. From 18 to 23, there are 6 shlokas. We are going to see all that today, but we are going to see all this again another time, because this is round 1 of shlokas 13 to 23, because there is so much to talk about these things. Shloka number 18 to shloka number 23 is actually give you actually the apex, the pinnacle of karma yoga. How karma yoga at its pinnacle slips into jnana yoga. By doing the actions, by doing your prescribed actions, by doing them the right way, yajna artha, by doing the right way as a yajna, how you will get into the jnana yoga mood, and finally the jnana itself. This is the content of 18 to 23, but the whole path is actionlessness. In fact, 18 to 23, we have to do it very carefully. So first let us take 18. I will give you the simple Sanskrit meaning, Sanskrit to English meaning, simple direct meaning, then we will discuss it thoroughly. Shloka number 18. Karman yakarma yav pashyete, akarmani cha karma yaham, sabuddhivan manushyeshu, sayukta krishna karma krithi. The meaning, direct English meaning I will give you. You will see how difficult it is to understand it. Karmani akarma Yav pashyet. Whoever sees, karmani akarma, whoever sees in karma, karmani, in action, whoever sees in action, akarma, akarma is non-action, whoever sees non-action in action, karmanya karmaya pashyet, he is going to say, such a person is great, in the last portion of this shloka. Sa yuktat Krishna karma krit, saha yuktaha, he is the one yogi, Krishna karma krit, he understands the universal implications of all karma, all actions. He understands karma, karma yoga totally. He does karma fully, completely, in totality. That's what it says. Sayukta Krishna karma krite. So, karmani akarma yav pashyet. Karmani akarma. In action, one sees inaction, non-action. Karmani akarma yav pashyet. Again, akarmani cha karmayaha. Akarmani karmayaha. In non-action, akarmani means in non-action, one sees action. So in action you see non-action, in non-action you see action, right? Sabuddhiman, he is the great wise man, he says. Sabuddhiman, manushyeshu, among all people, he is great. Sabuddhiman manushyeshu sayukta krishna karma krite. He is the krishna karma krite. He understands the karma totality. He understands very well. Now, what is the meaning of this? Of course, when you go to the further shlokas, you will get an elaboration of it, but that will go in a different direction. First, the meaning of this karmani akarma and akarmani karma. Simple meaning, we can even explain to a child. Very simple meaning. You go in a moving train, the trees or buildings appear to go in the opposite direction. Distant trees are going in the opposite direction. A child of 2 years old or 3 years old thinks that the trees are moving. You see? The child thinks, of course, as an adult you would know that they are not moving, they are stationary. The trees are stationary. But you will be only spiritually a child if you think that they are moving. So distant trees are moving. So distant trees are apparently doing action. They are moving. But actually it is, they are not doing any action. So karmani akarma yah pashyet. In that action of the apparent movement of the trees, apparent, in that action, apparent action of the movement of the trees, we understand that there is no action. Karmani akarma. By the way, Krishna is not talking about this trivial thing, just this train moving and tree is moving. I am giving you the example for you to understand, first of all, the logic of it. Then we will go to the philosophical implications of it in the next step. So, karmani akarma. In apparent action, we see non-action. Again, akarmani cha karmayaha. In non-action, we should see action. What is the elementary example that we can give? We can give a very elementary example. All of us have traveled in trains, and our trains, suppose it goes and stops in a big junction where there are several platforms, several lines. So our train is going in this direction, another train in the next line is going in the opposite direction. That also has come and stopped. Our train has stopped. Suddenly you feel that the other train is moving. It takes you half a minute, or you as an adult, It takes you half a minute or so by looking at the landscape in between poles and other things, that it is your train that is moving forward and the other train is not moving. Right? So, akarmani karma. Our train apparently is stationary, apparently, actually it is moving. We thought it was not moving. Okay? So, akarmani karmayaha. So, these are two simple examples of karmanya karmaya pashet, akarmani cha karmayaha. But what is the philosophical implication? Why is it coming here in the Gita? Gita is not telling you elementary statics and dynamics. No. The point is, right. Now, please show the slide. I will show you a slide called Atmapahari chart. Atmapahari chart. Yonyatha santam atmanam anyatha pratipadyate kinte nanakratam papam chorena atmapaharina. This is a shloka from Sanat Sujatiyam. Whoever has heard my Sanat Sujatiyam lecture would know. Now, what is happening? That is, somebody pinches me. I feel the pain. Pinches me. I feel the pain. I say, it's paining. But actually, who is it that is feeling the pain? This eye is wrong. You see, there are two eyes. Now I am talking philosophy. Advaita, two eyes. What are the two eyes? The false eye and the real eye. What is the false eye? Body, mind, intellect. Body, mind, intellect is the false eye. The real eye is inside. The real eye is nirvikari. It does not do anything. It is uncontaminated, unaffected, etc. You know all that. So, the contrast is between the false eye and the real eye. The false eye says, I feel the pain. But actually, the false eye has no business to use the eye. It is false eye. The real eye does not feel any pain. So the wise man who is talked about in shloka number 18, the wise man knows that the real eye does not feel any pain. It is the false eye that feels the pain. So the false eye, when it says, I am feeling the pain, that is action, in the apparent action, the wise man says, non-action. There is no pain. The real eye has no pain, does not feel it. Right? Karmani akarma yav pashe. The false eye action, the false eye says, I feel the pain. But actually that eye is the wrong eye, it is the false eye. So the real eye does not have any pain. Deha dharma, the false eye feeling the pain is the deha dharma, the body dharma. The body dharma, deha dharma is now ascribed by us, ascribed wrongly to the real eye. Right? You understand this? So, Sanat Sujatiyam says in that shloka, yonyata asantam atmanam anyata pratipadyate. Whoever considers untruth as truth, whoever explains truth the wrong way, yonyata santam atma, about the atma, about the self, whoever talks the truth about the self in the wrong way, yonyata santam atmanam anyata pratipadyate kimtena, what sin has he not done, kimtena nakritam papam chore. So far it is nothing great. Whenever somebody mixes truth and untruth, He has done something wrong. That is all what it says. First three quarters of the shloka. But the last quarter is the punchline. What is the punchline? Skinte nanakritam papam chorenatma apaharina. He is a thief. What thief he is? He is the thief of the self. How is it? Because the deha dharma is ascribed to the self. He has ascribed to the self, capital S. He has ascribed to the self the simple body dharma. It is the body that feels the pain that has been ascribed to the capital self. So the BMI, the wrong eye, whatever it does, it is apparent action. The real action, there is no action. Non-action, inaction. Karmani akarma yav pashen. Chorena atma apaharina. That is why that chart is called atma apahari. Atma apahari. There is another point here. The same atma apahari, that is deha dharma and atma dharma. Body dharma, BMI is dharma, and the self, dharma of the self. These are mixed. Here one kind of mixing I told you. Another kind of mixing. See, every night we go to sleep. Every night we go to sleep. And what happens? In the morning we say, I slept happily. Who slept happily? Who is this I now speaking? The speaking I is the false I. But the false I slept happily. False I did not feel any happiness. Because the false I, if at all it has to feel anything, it has to feel it through the mind, and the mind was sleeping. Mind was sleeping. So mind did not experience any happiness. So what is this? It is because it has gone and identified itself, merged in the self. The self is always of bliss, full of bliss. That bliss, this false I, when it wakes up, you see, it has borrowed it. It has borrowed it from that. You see, every time we identify ourselves with BMI, when we go to sleep, nothing happens. There is no question of BMI at all. It's all there, not there. When we come back, we again associate ourselves with BMI. So when we associate again with our BMI, that happiness of the self, which we have been in, there is no experience, there is no mind, which we have been in that bliss, that is borrowed by this BMI, and it says, I slept happily. So the Atma Dharma is transferred to the Deha Dharma. So this again, Atma Apahari, Atma has been stolen. You can now close the slide. So, karmanya karmaya pashyet akarmani cha karmayagam. So this is the philosophical implication of this karmanya karmaya pashyet akarmani cha karmayagam. Non-action, apparent action, you see non-action. Apparent non-action, you see action. This is the wise man who does this. We will understand more of it when we go to the further shlokas. So that is 18, very important 5-star shloka, profound meaning. Now in 19, he now explains the actionlessness. You see, just now he has said, in action, you see non-action. Right? So when the wise man does action, he sees only non-action, because it is the BMI that is acting. That is the whole point. BMI, body, mind, intellect. Kayena buddhya manasa. Manasa buddhya. Kevalai indriyairapi. Body, mind, intellect. These are the things we do, the actions. The I, the self, is not doing any actions. So the shloka number 19 says, the six shlokas, 18 to 23, should be got by heart, should be repeatedly thought about, meditated on, and then imbibed in us. Yasya sarve samarambha, shloka 19. Yasya sarve samarambha, kamasankalpa varjito jnanagnisagdha karmanam samahupandisambudha. Buddha, wise man, tam, him, we are going to say whom, tam ahuhu panditam. He is known as a pandita, as a scholar, as a wise man by great people. So now we are describing that person whom we are going to call great pandita. What is that? Yasya sarve samarambha kama sankalpa varjitaham. We start an action, samarambha. Sarve samarambha, all actions, all started actions. Kama sankalpa varjita. Kama is desire. Sankalpa is determination. Varjita, devoid of. Devoid of any desire. Devoid of the intention to do it. I am the doer has to be avoided. The thought I am the doer has to be avoided. Such whoever begins actions this way, yasya sarve, all his actions, kama, they are desireless. He does not claim the agency of the action. Yasya sarve samarambhaha kama sankalpa varjitaha. That person who is doing all this, jnanagni dagdha karmanam, because all his actions are consumed, extinguished, absorbed by jnanagni. What is jnanagni? Fire of wisdom. Fire of wisdom. Jnana agni. The fire of wisdom consumes all the actions. Such a person, samahu panditam vidha. So, start your actions desirelessly and remove the thought that you are doing the action. That wisdom, that knowledge, not only that knowledge, but the knowledge, the total knowledge that we are talking about, jnana, jnana agni. This is a famous phrase. In Gita, jnanakni dagdha karmanam, jnanakni dagdha. The fire of wisdom consumes all the actions. That person is called a great pandita. So he is explaining to you how you see non-action in action and action in non-action, how you are going to practice it, how you are going to apply it. Shloka number 18 is a general theorem, a mathematical theorem. Now he is applying it. 19. Yasya sarve samarambhaha kama sankalpa varjitoha jnanatmidaktha karmanam samahu panditam budoham. 20. He is further explains it. Tyaktva karma phala sangam nitya tripto nirashrayam karmanyabhipravrittopi naiva kinchit karoti sagam. Tyaktva karma phala sangam. Karma, action, phala, fruit, asanga is attachment, attachment to the fruit of action. Tyaktva, renouncing all attachment to the fruits of actions. Nityadruptaha, always satisfied. No, because there is no desire. He has thrown away all desires. So nityadruptaha, nirashrayaha, not resorting to anything as support. Resorting only to the self, capital self. That self as the only support. Such a person who has renounced all the attachment to the fruits of actions, who is ever satisfied because he has no more desire, who does not depend on anything because he depends only on the self, capital self. Such a person, karmani abhipravrittopi. Beautiful statement. Karmani abhipravrittaha api. Even though, api means even though. Even though he is involved, he is engaged in action, karmani abhipravrittaha api. Even though he is engaged in action, naiva kinchit karoti saha. Na eva kinchit karoti saha. Saha na kinchit karoti. He does not do a thing. Even though he is involved in action. Who is this he? Yasya sarve samarambaha tyaktva karma pala sangam nityasripto nirashraya. All the attachment to fruits of action he has thrown away, renounced. He is ever satisfied and he is not dependent on anything except his own self. Right? Such a person is not doing anything even though he appears to do the action, even though he is doing action. This is actionlessness. This is the definition of actionlessness. This is how he wants you to do things. This is how he wants you to discharge all the obligations. He is not tired of it. I think Krishna is inspired. Inspired is not the word, but I don't know what word to use. Krishna is inspired. So he goes on. Nirashayasachittatma. Next shloka, number 21. That is why I put all these things together. Nirashirya chittatma tyakta sarva parigraha shariram kevalam karma kurvanna apnoti kilbisham. You see, these expressions you cannot find anywhere in any literature. This, of course, in the Upanishads they are all there, but cryptically. Here they are beautifully given to you as what they call hassamala kavati, just as a fruit right in your palm of your hand. Nirashi, without any hope or desire. Yathachittatma, having controlled your mind by yourself. Yathachittatma, tyakta sarva parigraha. Tyakta sarva parigraha. Parigraha means possession. No, not only possession, something more. In Vedanta, parigraha means thought of possession. There is nothing wrong in being rich. But the thought that I am rich is wrong. Be very careful. That is tyakta sarva parigraha. Tyakta means renounce. Sarva parigraha. All thought of possession. You can possess a lot of money, you can possess a lot of property, but they are all given to you as a trust by God. This thought must be there. Everything is a trust given to you by God. In this life, just like a bank, in a bank, the cashier, she deals with lakhs and crores of rupees. In her own hand, she counts it, she writes it, she knows, she keeps it. She deals it for the whole day, every day. But she cannot have any thought of possession of that money, even one little bit of it. She does it. That is how all cashiers behave. That is how you have to behave with the so-called your own money, your own property in ordinary life. This is the regimen, Gita regimen for Advaitic living. That is it. Tyakta sarva parigraha. Underline this, he highlighted this word. Tyakta sarva parigraha. Renounce all thought of all possessions. Such a person, shariram kevalam karma. He does actions, he goes, he arrives, he earns money, he disposes it, all sorts of things he does. And then he does all his, discharges all his obligations. Shariram kevalam karma, purely by the body, mind, intellect. Shariram kevalam karma, by my body alone, he is doing, kurvanne, he is doing action. Napnoti kilbisham, he does not obtain any fault. He does not obtain any fault or blemish. Kilbisha means fault or blemish. Kurvan apnoti kilbisham, even though he is doing action by only his body. So his mind, he knows that it is not his money. He apnoti kilbisham. And then again he explains in 22, yadricha labha santushto dvandvatito vimatsaraham samasiddha vasiddhau cha krutvapi na nibadhyate. Yadricha lava santushtaha. Yadricha is accidentally. But I have told you already that it is not accidentally. It is yataha icha, God's will. by God's will, as if accidentally, you get something. Whatever comes by its own nature. Yadricha labha santushtaha. One is satisfied by whatever comes. Of course, immediately, historians, critics will say that this is how India lost all its innovativeness, this and that and that and this. That is not it. Here we are talking about spiritual ascent. For the spiritual ascent, you have to have yadricha labha santushta. Whatever comes, accept it as given by God. Dvandvatito vimatsaraha, dvandvatitaha. All dualities, dvandvatitaha, transcending all dualities. Matsa vimatsaraha, no jealousy. Look at it. He is talking about all these things, suddenly jealousy idea comes. Why does it come here? That is the beauty. Sahana avatu, sahana ubhunaktu, sahavityam karavavahai, tejasvinavadhi tamastu. All this is about education, working together and so on, prayer. And then it says, mavidvishavahai, let us not hate anybody. Let us not hate anybody. So this not hating anybody, that vimatsaraha, not having any jealousy, is a very important thing. It will come again and again, almost everywhere. You will see that. Yadrichalaba santushtaha, dvandvatito vimatsaraha, samasiddhava siddhau cha, siddhau asiddhau, samaha siddhau asiddhau. Success siddhi, asiddhi, failure, samaha, equanimous. Equanimous in success and failure. Such a person, kritvapi, even though he does action, nanibadhyate. Remember, Krishna is going to use this thought. It is now looks very, theoretically you are, okay, all right, you will accept it. But Krishna is going to say in 18, even if you have killed a large number of people, you will not be affected. Because that's what it says. Yadricha labha santushto dvandvatito vimatsaraha samasiddhava siddhau cha kritvapi na nibadhyate. Even though he had done it, he is not bound. He is not bound. Gatasangasya muktasya jnanavastita chetasaka. Now he raises the level to the jnani's level. Gatasangasya muktasya, all attachment is gone. Gatasangasya muktasya, he is almost released. Muktasya jnanavastita chetasaka, his mind is located, anchored, established in jnana, knowledge, supreme knowledge. Gata sangasya muktasya jnana vastita chaitasaha yajna yacharataha karma. He is doing actions. So he is talking from jnani, brahmajnani, sitapranya. Yajna yacharataha karma. Yajna yacharataha karma. He is doing his actions, prescribed actions, obligations, everything for yajna. Third chapter he said, yajna arthat karmanon yatra. So he is doing his actions only for yajna. What happens? Samagram praviliyate. Everything gets consumed, absorbed, extinguished. Praviliyate samagram, totally, completely. That is how one becomes actionlessness, actionless. I have told you many things today. It's a very important lesson. We will come back because there are more things here which I want to tell you. We will come for a second round with these shlokas in the next class. Swasti prajabhyah paripalayantam nyayena margena mahim mahishaham ko brahmanebhyah shubhamastu nityam lokas samastah sukhino bhavantu. Om Tat Sat.